What are you doing, Manny?
I can't fall asleep, so I figured I would try counting basketball bounces.
Counting sheep is a lot quieter.
But Lizzie, I'm just not tired. Who says we have to sleep at night anyway?
Let's see. Mom and Dad do, I do. Copernicus agrees with me. Just look at him. The sun goes to bed at night and so should you.
What do you mean the sun goes to bed? Where does it go?
I know what you're doing. You're just trying to get out of going to sleep.
If you don't tell me, then I won't be able to go to sleep because I lay here all night trying to figure out the answer. And I think better when I'm dribbling a basketball. And all my dribbling will go on and on all night, and you won't get any sleep.
The sun really doesn't go anywhere. We are the ones moving and spinning. In our solar system, the Earth turns away from the sun as it spins. The Earth spins and day begins. In a few hours, we'll be spinning around to face the sun. A new day begins! I'd like to get some sleep before that happens.
If we're spinning, then why don't I feel it? Do you remember the last time you spun me really fast on the merry-go-round at the park?
How could I forget? I called you and Copernicus the dizzy duo. The Earth is spinning, but we can't feel it because everything around us is spinning at the same speed, too. Oops.
Don't worry, sis. I do that all the time.
Hey, that gives me an idea. Let's use the light bulb for the sun, your basketball for the Earth, and we can use your glob of gum to show us where we are on the Earth. Well, actually, the sun is a lot bigger than the Earth. If Earth was the size of this basketball, then the sun would be the size of our apartment building. The Earth is a lot further away from the sun than this.
Okay, the sizes and distances are all wrong. But where does the sun go at night?
During the day, we face the sun, but the Earth is spinning. As the Earth spins away from the sun, we move into night. The Earth keeps spinning and we turn back to face the sun and a new day begins. It looks like the sun is moving across the sky, but we are just spinning past it.
So the Earth spins away from the sun and we have night. Does that mean that one part of the Earth is in nighttime and the other part of the Earth is in daytime?
That's a really great question, but I'll need another piece of bubblegum to answer that question. I just brushed my teeth and I'm not chewing bubblegum.
I can chew another piece.
I've got a better idea. I'll make you a deal. If you get some sleep, I'll get Mom to take us to the library in the morning and we can check out the simulation station.
The simulation station! I'm in. Turn off that light. I need to get some sleep.
What about your basketball and bubblegum?
You can keep it, sis.
Gee, thanks. I guess sharing is caring. The Earth spins and day begins. We were spinning all night and now we're facing the sun. It looks like the sun is moving across the sky, but we are the ones spinning past the sun. We've spun to see the sun. Are you ready to be amazed?
Am I ready to be amazed? Does the Earth spin around the sun?
I love our Saturday morning trips to the library. What books did you want me to find for you?
We need a few books that explain why we have night and day.
Let's start at the computer. A few simple clicks, and we should have a reference number. Here we go. Why we have night and day, SS 247. I'm guessing the SS stands for science section. I'll be right back with that book.
Do you think we should tell her that SS stands for simulation station?
It will be good to have a book. We can read it before bed tonight. It may help someone to fall asleep.
Thank you.
What are you doing? The simulation station is a hologram machine.
What? It makes me feel like a scientist.
Go ahead and start the station. I'll load the basketball and type in your question. Compared to all the planets in our solar system, the sun sits in the middle and all planets move around it. As the planets move around the sun, they spin. The Earth spins. The spinning of the Earth is what causes day and night. Because everything on Earth is spinning at the same speed, we can't feel it. When we see what looks like the sunrise and watch the sun seem to move across the sky, we are actually seeing the Earth spin away from the sun. It takes 24 hours for the Earth to make one complete rotation. That's why there are 24 hours in a day. As North America turns to face the sun, direct light from the sun hits the Earth. The direct light from the sun creates daytime. As the Earth spins away from the sun, North America moves out of view of the sun, and we see what looks like a sunset. Direct sunlight hits another part of Earth. So, in answer to your question last night, yes, Manny, we can easily see that when we have daylight on the other side of the Earth, it is nighttime. Without direct sunlight, North America is in nighttime. The Earth keeps spinning through the night until it faces the sun. The Earth has spun to face the sun. The Earth spins and a new day begins.
That was so cool!
Science is everywhere. You just have to start thinking and asking questions about what you see. Sometimes you just have to stop and wonder why.
I found a great book that should help explain why there is day and night.
Thanks, Mom. Lizzie and I can read it tonight.
That book looks like it will be great for exploring more.
The simulation station got me thinking. I know why we have day and night. The Earth spins to face the sun and we have day. The Earth spins and faces away from the sun and we have night. But why can we see the moon at night?
That's a great question, but to show you the answer to that, I'm going to need a flashlight, a bike reflector, and a powdered donut.
It sounds like a field trip into the basement!
Field trip into the basement sounds exciting, but we're replacing that powdered donut with a hard-boiled egg.
Science! Stop and try to wonder why!